Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? This garden is an absolute mess. Tidying it up was another thing that I wanted to do. It was on my to-do list, but we just haven't had time. So, you probably figured out by now that I have decided to move on from this map. Well, I say figured it out. I told you in the last episode. So, yeah, this is it for Melbury Estate. I got today and tomorrow's episode, and then that'll be the lot. The next map that I am going to be picking is either going to be Sandy Bay Redux version 3, Thornton Farm, or Higher Hills version 2.3. They are all on FSUK. Sandy Bay Redux version 3 has just been released and it looks absolutely fan-shmabulous. It looks awesome. So that is my personal preference. So I'm hoping that you'll pick that one for me. But don't worry, if you would prefer a different one, then pick a different one, because I've picked all three of these maps because I would like to play all three of them. It's just that Sandy Bay, I think, happens to be the best of the three. If you desperately want soil mod, now I explained yesterday my reasons for not particularly wanting to do a soil mod map, but if you do want me to, then that one is going to be Thornton Farm. I'm not doing soil mod on Sandy Bay, and Higher Hills isn't soil mod ready anyway. Higher Hills is the staff favourite, I think I said before, of these over on FSUK. It does look really good. It's originally a 2011 map that has been moved up to 2015, and it's had a couple of updates on it. It's looking fanshmabulous as well. So head down to the comment section down below. Let me know which one you'd like me to do. This is the final week for Melbury Estate. So which map do you want me to do next? Now, we have this combine that we've hired. I stuck the header onto the trailer and hitched it onto the combine. It's all ready to roll. So we'll do this. And also, by the way, I know that the 580 was the one that we picked and it was the one with the wheels. I wanted to try the one with the tracks today because we're hiring again. I thought we'd just test out the one with the tracks. So we're going to take this one up and we are finally going to do field 15. We have been talking about field 15 since we started. That one has been ready to harvest since we first turned up on this map and we have not yet done it. So today I'm going to get started on field 15. I'm not going to spend much of this episode doing combining though. Most of this episode will be dedicated to our baling. The baler is ready to go in that field. We've got all of this rowed up in the fields there beside me, and you'll probably hang on. I do apologise, I nearly forgot to turn those on. And yes, I realise I don't have traffic on at the moment because I turned that off for another episode that I was... It's a time-lapse, it's a one-off time-lapse that I'm doing for a different map. And it's basically I'm changing the appearance of the map quite drastically. I'll do the time-lapse video and subsequently upload the map to FSUK like I did with the last time-lapse series. When I'm done, but that's to sort of be done then. I don't know when it will be ready. I'm just sort of working on it when I've got time. I don't have a lot of that available at the moment. So let's get this one on up the road up here. I have got the Lamborghini with the Flegal Bull trailer. He's parked on the road over there. He's ready to go. We're gonna have to go straight into the field with this one, and I'm aware that we don't have a lot of time, so let me just get over towards the field a minute. There we go. Now, I'm going to try and do this from inside the cab, because I very often do the tricky stuff from outside the cab. I'm curious. See, I can't see anything. This might be a little bit ambitious, I think, because I've no idea. Oh, hang on. No, we've got the... which button is it? Left alt. There. I've got... camera here somewhere. Oh yeah, that's the trailer there. I can see the trailer. Right, left alt again, so I might be able to use that to see where I'm going. Am I squeezing in? Oh, I've just caught the gate there. I've jackknifed the trailer around quite a bit. It's there behind me, and now I'm going to ruin some of this crop, but I can see, and the wheels of that trailer should come out behind me. Now, I'm going to have to just go straight in. I am destroying a lot of the crop here, but we do have that little tiny camera. That's brilliant. I love that. Okay, now can I unhitch from here, or have I got to get out to do it? No, I've got to get out to do that. So let's get out, and we'll see what the damage is. So that one's there. I've got to move this trailer as well. Right, got that one. Let's climb back in. And nope, I'm going to do this from in cab. I'm driving on a massive amount of the crop here. This is almost heartbreaking, this is, but I couldn't think of any other way to get in here. If I can do that, get onto this one here. I know that's not very straight, but yeah, we'll just go with it. So now I've got to get past there. Ideally, I want to turn around and face the other way for when I do the first rounds. Right, now I can see behind me. I don't need to look behind me. So let's back up here a little bit. Almost to that trailer. There we go. Right. Let me just see. Do we have... Right, the straw swath is on. Okay, now I'm going to come out of cab so that we can unfold it. There we go. Come on. Hurry up. Hurry, hurry, hurry. And... Oh, I forgot to attach the PTO. Do apologise. That is Z normally. There we go. And that one is now ready to go. Starter up. That's ready. Let's come into cab. And this time we're going to go with... Oh, I could have used that view as well. That's inside the cab. And then we've got that view there. Now, last time I had a bit of lag because of that camera. Didn't work all that well. I think it's doing all right. Okay, I'm just going to do a little way along here, and then I will engage the auto combine and let that carry on, because I want to get on with the baling in the field. I think the foraging, I was hoping that we can do the foraging as well. Let me just see, auto combine, that's all okay. So I'll let that one carry on. I will jump out. Okay, so auto combine is going to carry on now. And the only issue that we've got left is that I've put that trailer right in the gateway, so I'm not going to be able to get a tractor onto it. Right. If I unhitch this one, have I got to start the tractor up? No, I don't. I can just do it like that. Start the tractor up. And now I've got to get in here. Now, the only thing that I can think of to do this, either I could drive through the hedge, or I can push this one in a little bit. I don't really like to drive through the hedge, because I feel that's more game-breaking than just nudging this one forward a little bit. If I could just nudge that forward just a fraction like that, there we go. Now I can come out here, and I've got to drive on the crop again, but we've already destroyed most of this crop here anyway, so that we'll live with that. Back up here. There we go. And hitch that one on. And now this one, at least I can turn really sharp. I do have that luxury because of the rear wheel steer on it. It does mean that we can turn really sharp. So we'll come into here. And no, I'm going to bring this one down here. Let me just come out of cab for this. I want to see it coming around. It is brilliant the way it does that. I can't remember who. I think it was McStallion that told me originally to just, you know, keep in mind that the wheels do turn. And it's sort of the sort of thing that you know about, but you forget all about until such time as you actually need to use it again. The turntable on that is not as sharp as I thought it was. So it's actually swinging the back of it round a little bit. So that wasn't too good, but it's all right. It's held. Let me just unhitch that one, leap back into the tractor. That header trailer can stay there. It's only on hire anyway, I suppose. We don't need to worry about sending it back anywhere. This is the only field that we're going to combine. I know that we've got loads of others that we've sown and are ready for cutting, but we've done lots of combining in this series, and I would rather finish up doing the grass and silage, to be honest. So that's what I will do. Pitch that one on. And I am going to be out of cab just to get in here, because I want to see that I can get in round. And... again, I'm driving all over this. There's not going to be much of this crop left in the gateway. We'll see how the combine handles it in a little while. Right, so he's at 78%. I'm going to go bombing round now and collect that. And then we should be ready to get started on our baling. Right, that one's unloading. And then we'll just let it carry on. I don't have a front weight on this one. I don't know if that's going to be an issue or not. I'm not really sure. What I do need to make sure is that we have this one ready for wrapping silage, because I'm going to turn this field into wrapped silage bales. So we got backloader console, I don't worry about that. Turn on baler, reset bale counter, activate work camera. Backloader console, what's that? I'm not sure, maybe I need to turn the baler on. There we go. Right, the wrap bales is off, and I've set the bale at 1.5 meters at the moment, which is bigger than the standard game bale. So let's 0.3, 0.4, 0.5. I'm not sure what the, I think the standard game bale is actually 1.3. Let's go with 1.4. We'll leave it at that. Change of drop mode, that's fine. We do want to wrap the bales though, so we'll turn that one on now. Yep, and we'll leave it at that. And now we'll start. So what's it going to be like? It's not actually picking anything up. It helps if you lower the pickup. Right, so we've lowered the pickup. And now it's picking it up. We have grass flying into the baler. Excellent. It would help if I drove over the windrow. And that windrower has done a great job. We got quite a thick, heavy windrow here. It's already gathering up. It's going. We're going to fill the pre-press chamber up completely in a minute at this rate. Now he's wrapping. I'm just going to go along. Oh no, he goes along slow anyway while he's wrapping so that you don't fill it up too quick and you don't have the next bale ready and raring to go a little bit too soon. So we come on round here. We're going to do all of this field as round silage bales, and then once this field is done, we'll then go on to... So that one's come off. Excellent. That bale is being wrapped in net and it's come out. That one's going to start wrapping. Slows us down. But we did get up this hill without any trouble at all. We didn't have any issues with that. That's excellent. I'm really pleased about that. And the next field up, I think we'll try and do that one with the forager. I would like to do... Although, the actual picture for Melbury Estate does show a bale of bales of silage being collected in this next field up, just down in the bottom corner. So I suppose we could sort of act that out a little bit. We'll see. I'll see what I feel like after this field. And what is the combine doing at the moment? That's at 59.8. The trailer is 33% full. Might have to go and check the combine in a minute. He may have stopped or got stuck somewhere. This is great. I do like these bales being sort of working like this. We'll have to see if you can put those bales straight in or if you've got to put them somewhere else. Let me just leap out a minute. We'll have a look at a bale. Doesn't actually do anything. Yeah, I don't have... There is a bale mod that tells you everything that there is to know about a bale. But that does look pretty cool. That combine has stopped, so I'm going to go over and check on that one a minute, and then I will come back. Right, apparently, auto combine, whilst it does auto fairly well, it doesn't like this. It's gotten hung up on that one being right in the middle there, and had a little bit of a accident. So, I think it's because it actually follows the line on one side of the combine, and so it doesn't follow what's happening on the other side of the combine, which is what would have caused that. So it like a minor conflict there, I think. I remember I don't want to go too fast. You can't overload it when you're leaving the auto combine to do it. If I come around here, I can try and... I don't want to overload it. I don't want to spend time having to unclog the combine today, because I want to concern myself with running, doing the baler, mostly. So we bring that one up along there. We'll start him on here. And there. Right, now that one's going to carry on. He'll do a few more rounds. I'm going to head back over to the baler. There we go. There's our baler. Chugging away. Wonder what this is going to be like from in the cab. Can I actually see, or is it just going to bounce me around too much? That actually looks pretty cool, the way it's travelling into the baler there. That does look pretty cool. Getting drawn in there. That's a really nice animation that it's got going. I really like that. It's actually not that far off of what a real baler looks like when you're sitting in the tractor looking at it. The only problem is that you've got to move. You find yourself moving a lot more here. When you're normally doing it, you sort of, you sit almost sideways so that you're watching in front and behind. You kind of swivel between the two. But obviously you've got to be jerking the mouse around a lot more with this one. Now, if I stop right here, that round bale, I should say round baler, but it's round bale, should stop when it hits us. Just have a look. Right, I don't want you going out onto the road, so if you just stop right there, thank you very much. Right, he has stopped now, that's okay. And I missed a great big chunk of it here, because I wasn't driving straight. I come around here, I think I've missed a little bit more as well. Crumbs, my driving down along here wasn't very good at all, was it? The Lexion has filled up. I'm not too worried about doing all of it. I just kind of wanted to see what that field would have been like. And yeah, I realise that we are sort of dropping a whole load of tasks right in the middle of it. But to be honest, when would be a good time to stop a farm? When would be a good time to sort of say, oh, I finished the tasks. It's a farm. The tasks never end. And that is one sort of difficulty that you do have when you want to transition from one map to the next, is when do you do it? So let me just bring this out, try a sideways view for us, zoom in a little bit, so you can see that, you can just see the animation just above the pickup as the grass is flowing up into it, and we can see the wrapper there working away, it's putting the plastic film on, or foil as it's some called in some places. There we go. It is a wonderful thing being able to do that, wrapping it up like that. Wheels just moving slightly off to the south there. There we go, that's that bale done. Yeah, we'll go into the next field. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to finish baling this field, and then we're going to go into the field of hay so that we can finish up this episode doing hay, because I'd like to do some of that as well. And tomorrow's going to be taken up doing the foraging up in the top field. This is the last bale for this field, just wrapping now. As soon as this one's finished, we'll change it so that it's no longer wrapping. So that one's going to come off. And there, and it's 25% in the main chamber at the moment. We've got no way of emptying it out, so I think it just changes over to the next crop. So if I press that, that should... wrap bales is now off. So hopefully it will stay like that. I emptied the combine out again, and he is on his way round for his third fill-up, which will then be a full trailer on the for the Flegal Bull, which I will take straight down to the village, and I'll tip it out down there. Right, now, this should wrap now. It should put the netting around it, and then tip it straight off. No, stop. Stop. Why are you wrapping? You're not supposed to be wrapping unless... Oh, unless it's gone... Is it chosen? Is it decided that one's grass? Why are you wrapping? I didn't want you to... You're supposed to be you're supposed to be hay, not silage. Or haylage, actually, because it's hay. Well, I suppose technically it should have wrapped it because there was grass in the middle of that one. Right. Wrap bales is now off. Right, let's see if it does it right this time. If it doesn't, we've got issues. Now, don't wrap. I'll go on a little bit further. We might have to turn the baler off. Ah, it's worked. Right, it's because there was grass in there. Ah, so excellent. So it didn't automatically sort of change it into the next type of crop. It said, no, you've got grass in here, so this one has to be wrapped. We can't not do that. Or it was because I turned it off to reset it. It was one or the other. It was something like that. So anyway, now that we've done a little bit of hay, I will... I suppose I ought to try and use the pecan mixer. I will get the pecan mixer ready for the next episode, and I'll bring it straight out to the field with one of the tractors, and we will chuck in a couple bales of silage, a couple bales of hay, and I'll tell you what. Let's just go around. This is just going to be messy. I'm not going to worry about finishing this, because we know that we're finishing this episode. We're finishing the series. I'm not going to worry about finishing the field. I'm just going to do another run up through here so that we just have one more bale of hay now. There we go. Right, that's 100% in there. So I will back up a little bit. There's the last bale. And then I'll go into the straw in there, and we will bale up a little bit of that straw. And then we will pick up the different bales, and we will chuck them all in. So let me just turn that one off. Pick that one up. So we'll go and bale a little bit of straw in here. I know that we got some straw bales already, but I think it'd be pretty cool if we could just do this. We'll step in through here, and I need to go and get that Lamborghini and empty the combine out in a minute. I'll do that in a minute. But I think it'd be pretty cool if we could just do this from the field. This end. There we go. If we could do this from the field, we could bring the pecan mixer out here and also bring out the New Holland loader, and we'll pick up a couple bales of silage, a couple bales of hay, and a couple bales of straw and lob them all in, because it's 64,000 litre capacity. It's not like it's going to not take six bales. And how many is in a bale? How much is in a bale? It's 4,000, isn't it? Is it four? Might be a little bit more. Let's just see. Let's come around here. So my question for this week is, which map do you want me to start next week? And the three maps in question are Thornton Farm, which is going to have the soil mod. Right, it's 4,000 for a bale. So Thornton Farm has got the soil mod on it, and the Sandy Bay Redux version 3, which has only just come out. That is absolutely fantastic. I won't be using soil mod on that, or it's Higher Hills version 2.3. I will put links to each of the maps in the comment section, in the description down below. If you could head into the comment section, let me know which map you want. My personal preference is for you to pick Sandy Bay, but obviously it is your vote. It is your game. You decide which one you want me to play. Okay? So let me just come around here, and then I will... That was terrible driving. What am I doing? Let me just stop here now. We'll leave that one there. I will switch this one off. I've got a few bales out, so we've tried out the krone in all three. It is a little bit untidy, but the next person that takes over the farm, the next farmer that comes and gets this, obviously he will be able to finish off this harvest, but I've got a couple more jobs that I want to do tomorrow so that I can finally wrap this up for good. So I will just go and get this, and I'm not going to do very much more in this field either. I might just let the combine do one more trailer full of grain, and that'll be about it, because I want to concentrate on having a go with the silage so we can at least say that we've done it. I apologise if this finish is a little bit messy, really. I should do this a little bit more tidily, but I just sort of suddenly twigged this week that we've only got 10 weeks, so time is really against us. And I figure it'd be better to do this, and then we can have a good look at another map rather than just having a few weeks on a map. We can't really do very much. So, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about it. Get them to come and watch me as well. That would be awesome. But again, thank you very much for watching. And until next time, goodbye and see you later.